Good morning, students. Good morning, everyone. Prakruti, my voice is audible? Yeah. Good morning. Good morning. Hope all of you are fine. Okay, so here you can see all the important formulae which we did last class, and this will be important for your board numericals also and for entrance also. So let us just try to remember what are this. What is this? If I ask you what is this, what will you say? The first one. In short, also you can write. Okay, so this is your Biot-Savart's law. Okay, this is your Biot-Savart's law, and this is the application of Biot-Savart's law to find magnetic field at a point on the axis of the circular coil. Okay, right. So let us once revise. Okay, so look here. If there is a current carrying wire, then there is magnetic field around the wire. If there is a current carrying wire, there is magnetic field around the wire. Okay, now at some point, see, just like electric field is found at a point, magnetic field is also found at a point. So suppose you want magnetic field at this point, then we write in vector form dB bar, which is equals to mu naught by 4 pi, some constant proportional to current. And then this is the cross product of which vector? DL bar and R bar. So this cross product will help you to find the direction of dB bar. So the rule is what? From DL to R. So DL cross R you have to do. Magnetic field will be pointing along the thumb. DL cross R. DL cross R. Okay. And if you take the magnitude both the sides, you will get A bar cross B bar magnitude is AB sine theta. This R will be here. So that R and R cube will cancel. You will get R square. So this is your Biot-Savart's law. This cross product, when you write in cross product, it is called vector form. And you have to take the vector form in such a way that when you take magnitude, you should get this. Then we applied this law to this circular current carrying loop. So you have to divide this loop into small parts, because magnetic field dB is due to only this part. This part is also called current element. Okay, and DL bar is chosen along the current. So for this part, current, you can see this loop has been kept like this. Okay, so for this part, current is coming out. So DL bar is here, R bar is here. R bar is what? From DL bar to observation point. So this R bar is from DL bar to observation point. So DL bar is here, R bar is here. You have to take cross product. Here you will get. To understand cross product nicely, I made this for, you know, first PU students actually. So you can see, this is A bar, this is B bar, and this is A bar, this is B bar, and this is A bar cross B bar. So if you take like this, A cross B, you get this vector. So this is your A cross B. So let me try to put, so A bar should be your first vector, okay? So DL bar is coming out, see, coming out first vector, A bar. Then R bar is this vector. So you can see dV bar is here. At this point we want, no, wherever you want, there you have to draw, no, vector, magnetic field. So DL bar is coming out. R bar is not like this for this, R bar is like this. So dB bar will be there. Similarly, this is the first vector. So here, DL bar is into the board. Current is going like this, remember. So DL bar is inside. So let me put DL bar inside. And then I have to put R bar here. R bar, I have to put it, how I have to put? So DL bar is here. Your second vector should be this side. So here, DL bar is here, R bar is here, this is here, right? So this vector should be kept somewhat like this, yeah. So you can see, A bar, the first vector is dl bar. Second vector is b bar, that is r bar is here. This is r bar. And you can see this is your a bar cross b bar. Okay, see here. So that is your dis db bar. Okay, students. Then what you have to do? You have to take components of these two, do the integration that we have done already. Then you will get this result. And if anyone can tell me what was the name given to this current into area? What was the name given to this current into area? Not magnetic dipole. Magnetic dipole is the name for this loop. This is called magnetic dipole. It is called magnetic dipole moment. Yeah. So this is current into area. Here also you can see that is called magnetic dipole moment. Okay. Then for straight wire, if current is I and you want to know magnetic field lines, how they look like, then you have to hold the wire. Thumb should be along the current. Curl of the fingers will give the magnetic field. Okay, like this. Like this. Okay, hold the wire. Thumb should be along the current. These lines are your magnetic field lines. At any point, if they ask magnetic field, you have to draw tangent to the line. So draw the radius, draw perpendicular. Draw the radius, draw perpendicular. Why I am saying like that? Because tangent should be perpendicular to radius. Now for circular current, this is circular current carrying wire. So you have to curl the fingers along the circular current carrying wire. Thumb will give you magnetic field. Here also you can see magnetic field due to this part is here. Due to this part is here. Total will be this side. No. Total will be this side. So at the center, if they ask, magnetic field is like this. So curl your fingers along the current, thumb will give you magnetic field. Here, thumb is the current, this is the magnetic field. Here, this is current, fingers are the current, thumb is giving you magnetic field at the center. But at other points also, there will be magnetic field. Obviously, right? Magnetic field is a region. Magnetic field is a region. So at other points also there will be magnetic field. How to know the direction? Very simple. This is the current carrying circle, right? Current carrying loop. So at this part, current is going inside. So if you consider this small part, it is going inside. So magnetic field will be like this. Okay? Apply this rule here for this small part. So magnetic field will be like this, like this, like this, like this. And then once it reaches the center, it becomes like this. Similarly, for this part, this is the current carrying wire. For this part, this red color you see, current is coming out. So magnetic field will be like this. We apply this rule. So it will be like this. So basically, if you have a circular current carrying wire, magnetic field will look like this. Okay, like this. It's like a fountain. It's like a fountain. But we only want usually magnetic field at the center. So for center, just apply this rule. Okay, students, fine. Then at the center, if you want to know the magnetic field, what you should do? Wherever is x, put how much x equal to? For center, this x should be how much? Zero, right? So just put x equal to zero in this formula, you will get this formula. Now this has to be memorized. So magnetic field at the center of a current carrying circular loop, where current is I, radius of the loop is r, is given by this formula, mu naught I by 2r. And if the circular current carrying is like this, magnetic field will be inside the board. If the current carrying wire is like this, magnetic field will be outside the board. So dot means outside, cross means inside. Okay, students. Then finally, I wrote the formula for magnetic dipole moment. Since you know this magnetic field should be along this direction, because this is now I can replace this current into area by m. Correct? No. So then if I put a vector sign here, you can see these two should be in same direction. So area vector, you know from Gauss law, area vector is always perpendicular to the surface of the area. Yes or no? So area vector will be either here or here. So magnetic moment will be either outside or either inside or outside, depending on how the current is flowing. Okay, students. So this is Beyer-Seibert's law. This is application of Beyer-Seibert's law. Very, very important for your board exam. I have tried to explain why magnetic field is here using this also. So I hope now it is very clear. And this is at the center. This is how you should find the direction. And this is called magnetic dipole moment. Fine, students. Okay. So let's continue today's class now. I will keep this. Today I told I will start with Ampere's law, but before that some few things are there, small things. Let us complete that also. So when I was teaching in for first PU also we have started. So I was teaching them this cross product. So they were not understanding because it's very difficult in online class. So I had to make this model and then they understood. Okay. Fine. So now let us try to find one small topic we will do. Magnetic field at the center. Please write down magnetic field at the center of an arc of circle. Oh, one more thing I think I forgot to tell you. If you have a straight current carrying wire, straight, then along this line, magnetic field will be always zero. That is because magnetic field is produced around the wire, not on the wire itself. So along this line, magnetic field will be zero everywhere due to this current. Okay, Okay. So now we want to find magnetic field at the center of an arc of a circle. Okay, students, so look here. So imagine this is the arc which carries current I. Now this will have some center somewhere here, right? Okay, this is the radius and current is I. So now I want to find magnetic field due to this arc. Okay, now for arc I must give you how much angle it makes. So this angle is phi, let us say. Without that phi, it is meaningless, right? You cannot tell me that I have given you arc, but I am not giving you this angle. Then how will I find magnetic field? So at this point, if I want magnetic field, I will apply Beyer-Seibert's law. So you have to take a small part of the wire. This is very easy. Small part, let us take here. So this is your DL bar like here. And R bar was what? This small R bar was from DL bar to your observation point, which is my observation point I want at the center. So this is my observation point. So this will be my R bar, which is nothing but your radius vector distance. But it is towards the center, not away from the center, because R bar is from DL bar to the observation point. From DL bar to observation point. Okay. So let us see what is the magnetic field here due to this part. Only due to this part. Apply this law. This is only to find direction. This is the magnitude. So what will be the answer? dB will be mu naught by 4 pi. I, length of this small part, is dl. Sine of. What is the angle? dl is here. R bar is here. So dl is along the current. Along the current matlab, along the tangent of this circle. And this is your R bar. So what is the angle? dl bar is here, r bar is here. So what is the angle? 90 degree, right? So sine 90 degree divided by small r square. Small r means again from here to here. That is the radius of the circle. So capital R square I can write. Now you know sine 90 is 1. So this is 1 because this is sine 90. Correct? Now we have to check where is the direction. So dl bar is here, r bar is here. So dl cross r inside the board. So magnetic field is inside the board. What about due to other parts? What about due to this part? Dl bar will be here, r bar will be here. So dl cross r again inside the board. So the beauty is for every part, it is inside the board only. Take this part. Current is going this way. This is your R bar. So dl cross R, this smaller angle, dl cross R inside the board. Okay, students. So for every part, dl bar magnetic field is inside the board. So all the magnetic field due to every part are in the same direction. Then no need to take components. Directly you can add. So total magnetic field will be integration of this. Constants you take outside. Constants you take, radius will not change. So the only thing left is dl. Last class when we did this, it was circumference of the circle. But this cannot be circumference because this is only this much part is only there. So this will give you mu naught I by 4 pi r square into integration of dl, matlab this total length of the arc. So integration of dl will be length of arc. I hope you know from mathematics that if this is the arc S, this is the angle theta, and this is the radius r, how are they related? Arc length is angle into radius. So it will be angle, here angle is phi, into radius. So angle into radius. Okay, students. So your radius will cancel, one radius will cancel. So finally, the formula will be mu naught by 4 pi, mu naught by 4 pi I phi by r. So this is the formula for magnetic field at the center of a arc. Magnitude is this. Direction very easy. Put your fingers along the current, thumb will give you magnetic field. If current was like this, it will be out. Okay, here current is like this, it will be inside the board. So this cross here represents the direction of magnetic field. So this is more easy than the axis one. On the axis one, when this was the circle and here was the point, that time dB, 1 dB was here, 1 dB was here. So we had to take components. Here, no need, because due to this part also, due to this part also, due to this part also, everywhere if you take dl cross r, dl cross r, dl cross r, dl cross r, all are inside the board. So we need to memorize this formula. And how will you be able to memorize? When you apply this formula some number of times. So if they give you arc of any circle at the center of the arc, the formula for magnetic field is mu naught by 4 pi I phi by r. So what is phi? Phi is the angle subtended by the arc at the center. So this phi is this. And r is the radius. And I is the current here. Right down. Please don't take just screenshot and all. Screenshot you should take if I write only formula everywhere. Like previous one, you could have taken screenshot, but these things you should write so that you can practice and remember. Done? Yeah. Tejaswini, done this problem? Okay. Tomorrow's class will be uploaded at 9:30 only, but it will be recorded video. Okay, so let us apply this formula now and check. Some different examples we will do. Let us say I give you complete circle, which I have done already. At the center, what will be magnetic field? Now, for complete circle, what will be this angle? This is the angle phi. For complete circle, this angle will be 360 degree. but never write 360 degree. Always write in radians. So for complete circle, this angle will be 2 pi. So substitute 2 pi, you will get mu naught I 2 pi divided by 4 pi r, which very nicely gives you the same formula. Mu naught I by 2 r. Pi pi cancel. 1, 2 will cancel and you will get exactly the same formula which I showed you before. Okay, let us do for semicircle. So suppose I give you one semicircle at this point. Current is I, okay, I. So magnetic field will be how much at the center? For semicircle, what will be the angle? This angle, if this line was here, this line is here, this dot dot line is now here and this is here. So this will be pi. So now your phi will be pi. So what will be your magnetic field? Apply this formula, mu naught I by 4 r. Why 4 r? Because if you put pi here, pi pi will cancel. So again, easy way to remember is what? For full circle, this is the formula. For semicircle, half of that you can write. Okay, students. By the way, why these two straight wire were not considered here in this problem? This straight wire was not considered to find magnetic field because this point is on this line. And just now I told, if you have a straight wire, then magnetic field along this line will be zero due to this current. Okay, students. That's why I did not worry about this straight part. So these two will not produce magnetic field here. Only this will produce, and direction will be into the board. Direction is into the board. All these are very, very important for your NEET exams as well as CET exams. Try this one. So let's say current is going like this, okay, I like that, and at the center this angle is suppose 60 degree. I may give you 60 degree, but you shouldn't write 60 degree in the formula. I know it is difficult for you to type because mu naught, it is difficult for you to write. So what will be magnetic field now? Mu, what is the formula? This is the formula for R. Mu naught by 4 pi I by R into phi. What will be phi for this? 60 degree means pi by 3. This is 60 degree. 180 degree by 3, right? Pi means 180 degree. So pi by 3. So that will be mu naught I by 12 R. Mu naught I by 12 R. Your pi will cancel. Again, I don't have to worry about this straight wire and this straight wire because this center lies on this line. So these two will not produce magnetic field here. Of course, you are thinking, what if it is like this? What if this line was like this? Then you have to find magnetic field here also. That is for JE. That I will do in recorded video. But please, NEET students also should see. Now see something very nice, okay, something very interesting result, and I want you to remember the result. Suppose there is a circular current carrying wire and I put a battery here. Okay, then you can see this upper part and this lower part can be treated to be in parallel or series. This upper part will have some resistance. This lower part will have some resistance, right? So I can consider this upper part and lower part. I can replace them by like this or not. This lower part, whatever resistance it has, I can write here. This upper part, whatever resistance it has, I can write here. So it can be considered to be in series or parallel. In parallel, right? Okay. So please remember, this upper part and lower part are in parallel. Let us say this length, this whole length is L1 and this length is L2. This part has length L1, this part has length L2. This is the center. So question is, find magnetic field at center. So whatever current comes from here, that current will divide here I1 and here I2. This is parallel. This is not like this. Okay, this is not like this. Now look carefully. Due to upper part, magnetic field will be like this. Right? So let me first draw this angle. So let's say the lower part makes an angle phi. Then upper part will subtend what angle? Upper part will make 2 pi minus phi. Correct or not? 360 degree minus phi. Okay. Now, this upper part will produce magnetic field inside the board. Lower part, you can see, curl your fingers along the current. So this upper part will produce magnetic field inside the board. Lower part will produce magnetic field outside the board. So let us say due to upper part, magnetic field is B1. So B1 is magnetic field due to upper part. And B2 is magnetic field due to lower part. That means upper part will have magnetic field inside the board. Lower part will have magnetic field outside the board. So the two magnetic fields are in opposite direction. So total magnetic field at the center will be B1 minus B2. Because two vectors, when they are in opposite direction, resultant is difference of the vectors. Difference. Okay. So let us find the ratio of these currents. You know that upper part and lower part are in parallel. So you can write voltage here and voltage for lower part should be same. In parallel, voltage is same. So current in the upper part is I1. Resistance will be rho L1 by area. Lower part potential difference will be current into resistance of lower part, rho L2 by area. These two are resistance of upper part and lower part. And since you know they are in parallel, voltage should be same. So current into resistance should be same. That means you will get I1 by I2, rho A will cancel, L2 by L1. Now if I say the radius is capital R, please be careful, okay? R1, R2 is resistance. This is resistance. This capital R is radius. So what will be L2? Let us write L2. This is this arc. So L2 will be angle into radius. And this L1 will be angle into radius. So this is the ratio of current. Equation 1. Now let us find ratio of these magnetic fields. B1 by B2. What is B1? Magnetic field here due to this upper part. Since it is arc, I can apply the formula for arc. What is the formula for arc? Just now I told, mu naught by 4 pi I phi by R. That was the formula. So for upper part, the angle is 2 pi minus phi. So mu naught by 4 pi, current is I1 in the upper part, angle is 2 pi minus phi divided by R. What about B2? B2 is due to lower part. Mu naught by 4 pi, current is I2. Current is I2 in the lower part, angle is phi divided by R. This formula you know already. You can see many things will cancel. mu naught by 4 pi, mu naught by 4 pi r r. So b1 by b2 will be equal to I1 by I2 2 pi minus 5 by 5, right? But I1 by I2 I have done here already. This RRR will cancel. So 5 minus 2 pi minus 5. 5 minus 5 divided by, sorry, 5 divided by 2 pi minus 5. This is your I1 by I2 into 2 pi minus 5 divided by 5. So what will be this? Equal to how much? So the ratio is equals to 1. With this and this will cancel, this and this will cancel. So surprisingly, the ratio of the magnetic field here due to upper part and lower part is 1. That means B1 is equal to B2. So what will be the resultant magnetic field? The resultant magnetic field here will be 0. So what you should remember? The result. Provided it is done this way. Okay. Now don't tell tomorrow if I say current is like this. Don't say here it is zero. That I did not say. For this you can see. This part will also produce inside. This part will also produce inside only. But here this part will produce magnetic field inside. This part will produce outside. And then when I compare the ratio of the magnetic fields, I get 1. So it's a very beautiful result. You can apply this for different diagrams. First you write this. So total magnetic field is very interestingly 0. For entrance exam, if this question comes, don't do derivation, just write the answer. So next time if I say like this, if there is a square loop and here I put a battery like this and current will divide here. Here I1 will go, I1, 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 and here I2 will go, right? This I, I2. And if somebody says what is magnetic field here, no need to do derivation, 0. Same technique you can think. So they may give you triangle like this. If they apply magnetic field here like this, then current will divide here and here. So at the centroid, for triangle center we say centroid, here again magnetic field will be 0. So any shape they may give, pentagon, hexagon, I don't care. For circle only I have proof. No. So for circle if I have proof, it is true for any side. So these kind of questions are very common. Many students will spend time in deriving it. No need to derive. Directly it will be zero. Provided it is done this way. Provided the current divides here. Otherwise we cannot say like that. Note, sometimes they will give you two circles like this. This will have radius R1, this will have current I1. This will have radius R2, current will be, this is like this, this is like this. And at the center, if they want magnetic field, due to this circle, it will be inside. And since it is complete circle, what is the formula? Mu naught I by 2R. But I am calculating due to this circle. No. So I should write I1 R1. Direction is inside. Inside matlab cross. What about magnetic field due to this part at the center? It will be outside. Formula will be, since it is circle, for circle at the center, mu naught I by 2R. But for this circle, current is I2, radius is R2. This is dot. So they are in opposite direction. So I should put minus. So this is one very important example. Now they may give you the values of the current. Sometimes the value of the currents will be same. And radius of this will be twice of this. Or radius of this will be four times of this. You can substitute and get the answer. suppose I keep one circular current like this, I1, and another like this, I2. Okay, so they are perpendicular. One circle is like this, one circle is like this. So due to I1, you can see, due to I1, curl your fingers, magnetic field will be here, D1. And due to I2, it will be up. Now you cannot directly add or subtract because they are perpendicular. They are neither in same direction nor in opposite direction. So what will be B1? Mu naught I1 by 2R1. B2 will be mu naught I2 by 2R2. And total will be root over B1 square plus B2 square. Why root over B1 square plus B2 square? Because these two are perpendicular. So you know from parallelogram law, resultant will be here. Okay. By the way, if you substitute these two here, common you can take outside. Mu naught by 2 is common. Root over I1 square by R1 square plus I2 square by R2 square. If currents are also same, radius are also same, then you can just write I square by R square, I square by R square 2 times. So it will be root 2 times mu naught by 2 I by R. If currents are same, radius is same, just substitute and check. If currents are same, radius are same, just substitute here I, R, R and check. Okay, so let us now continue with our board syllabus. We have to study now something called Ampere's circuital law. Ampere's circuital law. Finish it. So this right hand curl rule, please keep in mind. So let us understand what Ampere's circuital law says. Listen carefully. This is the partner of basically Gauss law in electrostatics. So Gauss law, if you remember, helps you to find electric field due to some charge distribution like line charge, sheet of charge, spherical charge. Similarly, once the current distribution becomes complicated, till now we have found magnetic field due to circular loop and arc of loop. That was easy. But suppose I give you straight line, straight current. Suppose I give you solenoid kind of current. Okay, so those kind of current distributions are complicated. So by using Biot-Savart's law, it becomes more difficult. So Ampere's circuital law will help you to solve that question more easily. How to find magnetic field? Okay, so this gives you, what is the role of this? The role of this is to find magnetic field at a point due to current distribution. Just like Gauss law is used to find electric field due to charge distribution, Ampere's circuital law is used to find magnetic field at a point due to current distribution. That is the first thing to understand. Now, what is the meaning of this circuital law? Listen carefully. There is no proof of this. Okay. I mean, obviously there is proof, but proof is not there for our purpose. So for us, there is no need for proof. Applications are there. Proof is not required. Now look carefully. What this says, this law says is, You make any loop. This is not current loop. Okay. This is imaginary loop, which is called Amperean's loop. Amperean loop. Just like in case of Gauss law, we used to make what kind of surface? Anyone remembers in Gauss law? Sometimes cylindrical we made, sometimes spherical we made. So that time it was called Gaussian surface. Okay, and it was a closed surface. Closed surface. Similarly, in Ampérian, when you apply this law, you have to imagine a closed loop. So Ampérian loop, which is always a closed loop. Now check at different points, different points, is there any magnetic field or not? Check. You can put a compass needle and check what is there. So if there is some magnetic field, there will be some direction of magnetic field, yes or no? And this dl bar. So this time this dl bar is small part of the loop, small part of Ampérian loop. Okay students, don't confuse with this small part of Ampérian loop. Let me show that like this. Okay, sorry, dl bar will be wherever the loop is going. So this is your dl bar. Magnetic field at that point can be anywhere, no? So let us say this here. So at this point on the loop, you choose a small length vector. So this is your length vector, and this is your magnetic field at this point. Okay students, now you take dot product of those two. Okay, just like in Gauss law, we used to take dot product of electric field with area vector. You remember, no? This was called electric flux through this small area. Unfortunately, no name is given to this. You cannot call it magnetic flux, okay? Because for flux, it should be area. This is not area, this is length, small part of the Ampérian loop. Small part of the Ampérian loop. Then what you do, repeat this process for this part also, for this part of the loop. Then repeat this for this part. Matlab, for this part also, find the magnetic field, take dot product. For this part also, repeat. For this part also. Like this, you repeat this dot product for every part of the loop. Then you integrate. Since it is a closed loop, we put a circle here. Okay? So this is always equal to, according to Ampere circuit law, the current inside the loop. Inside the loop means, you have to understand, inside the loop means, if this is the surface, see, if there is any loop, no, if there is any loop, there will be some surface bounded by the loop or not. Some girls will do embroidery, or what it is called, I forgot, embroidery or something. Okay, so they will take some white cloth, they will put a ring, and there they will, you know, draw nice diagrams and all. Not with hand, they will sew. So that ring you think as the loop, that ring, and that white cloth is the surface. That white cloth is the surface. So when I write current inside the loop, it means any current that is cutting this surface. So let us say this much is the total current passing through the surface, which is enclosed by the loop. What is this surface? Let me write here. This is surface enclosed by the loop. Enclosed by loop. And in Gauss law, if you remember, we used to write here what? Charge inside. Here we don't write charge inside. Here we write current inside the loop. And there we used to divide by epsilon naught. Here we have to multiply by mu naught. So this is your Ampere's circuit law. I will write in words also, don't worry. But this is the process, this is the technique. Since proof is not there, I wanted to explain to you slowly what all these things are. So basically, let me repeat once more. Whenever you apply Ampere's circuit law, you have to imagine a closed loop. Just like whenever you apply Gauss law, you have to imagine a closed surface. Please understand, this is an imaginary loop, which is called Ampérian loop. It is not the loop that carries the current. Here the wire that carries the current is this wire. So do not think this is wire which carries current. therefore do not think dl bar is along the current this time. This time dl bar is along the loop, and the loop depends on you, depends on symmetry, what kind of loop you will choose. As we do more application of this, you will come to know what kind of loop you should choose. So first you have to imagine a closed loop. Okay students, once you imagine a closed loop, for different parts of the loop, take the dot product of magnetic field at that part with the length vector of that small part. Take dot product, then repeat that till you come back to the same point. So integrate or add all the dot product, understood? And that should be equal to mu naught times the current passing through this surface, which is enclosed by the loop. So that is your Ampere circuit law. Now, in case of Gauss law, we used to write like this. If you remember, E dot dA charge inside divided by epsilon naught, right? So in Gauss law, charge produces electric field, and some relation was there. Here, current produces magnetic field. That is how you should remember. Current produces magnetic field. Okay, and here we calculate with respect to area. Here we can calculate with respect to loop, some length. Now, the easy thing about Gauss law was this was given a name. This was called electric flux. Electric flux. Problem is, no name is given to this. No name is given. So you have to write what it is actually. Similarly, if no name was given to this, let us say, no name was given, then what will you call this? This is called surface integral of electric field. Why surface integral? Because we used to go from one part of the surface to another part of the surface and calculate this dot product. You remember, right? So this is called surface integral. If no name was given, I would have called it surface integral of electric field. Can you now think what I should call this? If this is called surface integral of electric field, what I should call this? Any name you can think? Line integral. Very good. Sanjay has told linear. Linear you can say, but we say line. Okay. In exam, we write line only because that is how it is stated. So now let me give you statement. In exam, what you have to do? In exam, you have to write the statement and write this formula with one diagram. And your diagram need not be all these things you don't have to do. Just you show the loop. Show dl bar somewhere, dl bar and magnetic field. Okay. Okay, so now let us write the statement. Please write the statement. This part is what? The line integral of magnetic field. This is a very important statement. That's why I'm writing in the board. The line integral of magnetic field around a closed loop, which is also called Amperean loop. This you don't have to write. The line integral of magnetic field around a closed loop is equal to mu naught times the net current through the surface enclosed by the loop. Again and again I am telling you, every loop will have some surface. If the loop is imaginary, the surface also will be imaginary only, but once you imagine a loop, there will be a surface. So the current should be through this surface. Okay, make a note. Don't write this, obviously. So again, the proof of this is not mentioned in the syllabus, so we will not do it. I think B.M. Sharma may have done it. So you can check, those who are interested to know the proof, you can check the derivation. I will not do because it is not there. But application we have to do. Okay, so please you have to understand what I am doing. So you have to choose any kind of loop, any kind of loop. But then in Gaussian surface, in Gauss law also, you can choose any closed surface. But we always chose the closed surface in a very smart way. We have to choose it in such a smart way that angle between area vector and electric field vector, that angle should be known. If that angle is not known, then we cannot find electric field. Similarly, when you apply Ampere's circuital law, you have to choose the loop in such a way that the angle between these two, that should be known to you. If you don't know about that, then it is useless. So though I am saying this law is true for any kind of loop, we are not going to apply it for any kind of loop. We are going to think carefully and decide what kind of loop we want to find magnetic field due to some kind of current distribution. If possible, say this 2-3 times. In class, if you remember, I used to ask you to read 3 times and all, but now it is difficult. Even if you say, I don't know whether you will say or not, okay, I won't be able to judge also. So some few things are, you know, left on faith. I have some faith on all of you that you are listening to the class properly. Any doubt comes, you can message, you can call, but please listen carefully. Okay, let us do application now. The first application is the simplest one, which is the most common one for board exam. Most common one. Find using Ampere's circuital law. Ampere's circuital law. In exam, you should explain the terms that I is current, B is magnetic field. That much you have to explain. And don't worry, students. If you know, our Edushine team has always been, you know, we always give importance to board also. If you see our results, we have always been in the top 15 at least all the years. This time we did so good in board also. So during the last 1 month of your board exams, we are going to prepare you of how to write each answer properly. What are the important questions for board exams? What are the important numericals from every chapter? And those students who are not able to do all the numericals, for them also, we will try to tell which chapters you can skip for doing numericals, so that even then, even after skipping those chapters, even then you will be able to do all the questions in your board exam. So we will be mentioning all that during the last 1 month like that. So don't worry about the board exam part. Right now, just concentrate on understanding. Because if you understand, no, you will remember. If you remember, you will be able to write in exam fast. See, writing fast is very important. If you are not able to write fast, you will not be able to complete the 70 mark questions. And you have to write some extra questions also, so that if by chance one or two mistakes, you have done silly mistakes, which most students will say, silly mistakes if you do, then at least the other extra questions will help you to get the marks. So that we will prepare you. You should not worry about that. By that time, I hope we will be able to interact, you know, face to face. Okay, let us start. So using Ampere's circuital law, find magnetic field due to an infinitely long straight current carrying wire. You all know that current produces magnetic field and current flows in wires. So depending on the shape of the wires, the magnetic field will change. So here the shape is simple kind of shape. It is a infinitely long straight wire. So let us say the current here is I. Okay. Now, to choose the loop, first you should have some knowledge of how the magnetic field lines look. If you don't have the knowledge of how magnetic field lines will look, then you cannot choose the loop also, how the magnetic field lines look. But already, I think in school days also, students, I hope you remember, you used to pass, you know, a straight conductor through some cardboard and you pass current, and then you will put iron powder on top of the cardboard, and you will see they will form circular shape, right? So from there also you know that magnetic field, put your thumb along the current, so magnetic field will look like this, right? This is how magnetic field lines will look. So these are your magnetic field lines. Okay, now at some point you want magnetic field, let's say this point, which is at some distance r, let's say r, at some point you want. No, now wherever you want, those who are writing with pencil, you can draw dot 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 lines, dot 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 lines. Okay, now wherever you want magnetic field, through that point you have to draw a Ampere's loop. Can you tell me I think it is easy, can you tell me what kind of loop you should choose here, so that you will know the angle between magnetic field and the loop? What kind of loop should you choose? If the magnetic fields are circular, what kind of loop should you choose? So the kind of loop you will choose is circular only. So this is my Ampere's loop, which coincides with one of the magnetic field lines. So this is my Ampere's loop. Why I have chosen circle? See, now let me calculate the left side of Ampere's circuital law, integral of B dot dl. This was the left side of Ampere's circuital law, yes or no? Yeah, correct. Tanuj is correct. So you are going to apply what? Ampere's circuital law? No. So start with the left side of Ampere's circuital law. This is the left side. Now, what is angle between magnetic field and dl? What is dl? Again, remember, choose the loop. dl matlab a small part of the loop, and in whichever way you go, this way or that way, that is your wish actually. So that dl, that dl is in whatever direction you are moving. So for this loop, I am going to go this way. Magnetic field is also that way only. So at every point, if you choose some dl here, dl will be tangent, magnetic field also will be tangent. So both dl and magnetic field are in same direction. Why? Because I have chosen circular Ampere's loop, circular. Because magnetic field is also circular, Ampere's loop is also circular. So at every point, dl, which is along the loop, and magnetic field will be in same direction. So this will give me what dot product? Bdl cos 0. You will choose Ampere's loop, but the question was what shape you have to choose. Should I choose some random kind of shape? No. If you choose some random shape, then dl will be along the loop. No. This dl that I write is always along the loop. Along the loop. So please revise the part where I taught Ampere's circuital law, where I explained Ampere's circuital law. This was along the loop. So if your loop is circular, then this will be also along the tangent. This is also circular, so this will be also along the tangent everywhere. So angle between these two will be same direction, means angle between these two will be zero. So this will give me integral of BB. Now, since I have chosen circular loop, every point is at same distance from the wire. This is the wire, I have chosen circular loop. So every point is at same distance. That means magnetic field magnitude must be constant in the loop, okay, in the loop. I am not saying when you go from here to here, magnetic field will be constant. In that loop, when you integrate, when you go from one part to another part, everywhere this B will be constant. So you can take it outside. Okay. Now, what is dl? Length of the small part. If you integrate length of the small part, you will get total length of this loop. Total length of this loop will be circumference. And circumference of this circle will be 2 pi r. So 2 pi r. This is your equation 1. So what I did, I calculated the left side of Ampere's circuital law. Directly also you can do. So now, according to Ampere's circuital law, what it says, line integral. I keep saying so that you will remember. Line integral of magnetic field around a closed loop, and that loop will have some length vector, dl vector. That is equal to line integral of magnetic field around a closed loop is equal to mu naught times current passing through the surface, this surface. So is there any current passing? Yes. How much? I. So I will write I. Now left side we have done the calculation already. This product will be B dl cos 0. B is constant because I have chosen circular loop. Every point is at same distance from the wire. So B will be constant in the loop. So we got B into 2 pi r. So therefore, what will be magnetic field? Magnetic field will be mu naught I by 2 pi r. So that is the formula for magnetic field at a distance r from the wire. This r is the perpendicular distance, remember. What is this r? Perpendicular distance between the wire and the observation point. P is your observation point. I have seen in my teaching career that many students are confusing with the formula of magnetic field due to wire and due to circle. So don't do that. For a circle, it is mu naught I by 2r at the center. And capital R is the radius. Radius. For an infinitely long wire, at some distance small r, magnetic field is mu naught I by 2 pi r. So don't confuse between these two formula. Here capital R is radius. Here small r is not radius or something. It is just the perpendicular distance between the wire and the point. Once you make the loop, then it becomes the radius of the loop. But if you want magnetic field, you just need to know the perpendicular distance between the observation point and the wire. Perpendicular distance. And this pi you should not forget. This pi. So this is how we apply Ampere's circuital law to find magnetic field due to an infinitely long current carrying wire. So make the loop, calculate the left side. If you want directly here also you can do. You can write this derivation here also. I think that is how in EPL I have done. But you should choose the loop in such a way that wherever is magnetic field, there should be your dl vector so that you will know the angle is zero. Done? Okay. So please remember the formula mu naught I by 2 pi r. Mu naught I by 2 pi r. Okay. Now one small topic I will, this one I will just show you. I will not be able to prove it because again I did not prove using that Biot-Savart's law. So if the wire is finite, okay, if the wire is finite, if the wire is finite, So the derivation which we did was for infinite wire, right? So suppose the wire is finite wire up to here. So these are the ends of the wire, and you want magnetic field at some point here. Let's say here. This is observation point. So the first thing you should do is find the perpendicular distance. That is your R. Okay. Then what you do? From the two ends, you make these lines. From the two ends, you make these lines to the observation point. Call this angle alpha, and call this angle beta. Then the formula for magnetic field, only formula we will study at this point. Magnetic field is mu naught by 4 pi I by R sine alpha plus sine beta. So this is the formula. Again, not so difficult to remember, right? Mu naught by 4 pi is that constant. You know it is proportional to current. And when we did the derivation for infinite wire, what did we see? There is R in the denominator. This R. So same R will be here also. Except now what will happen, if it is finite wire, this part will come, this extra part will come, which you have to remember. And this is 4, okay? So let us apply this formula for infinite wire. So if it is infinite wire, and you want magnetic field at some point, if it is infinite, both the sides. If it is infinite, here you are not able to see. If it is infinite, both the sides, then what? How to find this alpha? I told. First, draw this line, perpendicular line, which I made already. No. Then from this end, you have to draw this line. But if this is at infinity, that line will be like this. Right? This. If this point is going far and far, this line will go like this. Like this. So ultimately, this line will become parallel to this line. So this line will become parallel to this line when this point will go to infinity. Already you know that parallel lines meet at infinity. So if this point is going to infinity, wherever they meet, these two lines will become parallel. If these lines become parallel, what will be alpha? What will be alpha? If this line becomes like this, and this line becomes like this, what will be alpha? 90 degree, right? So alpha will be 90 degree, beta will be 90 degree. So now put these values here. Check what will be the formula. Sine 90 plus sine 90 will be 2, 1 plus 1, and 2 will cancel with 4. You will get the formula which I derived. So this is how you should check whether you wrote the correct formula or not. This is how you can check whether you wrote the correct formula or not. Because if the wire is infinite, this alpha will be 90, this beta will be 90, and when you put here, you should get the formula which I just derived using Ampere's circuital law. Yeah, pi by 2. Sine pi by 2 is also 1. So again and again I am telling, if this point goes to infinity, this line will be parallel to this line. Because parallel lines meet at infinity. Okay, second one let us see. So they may say, the wire is like this. It is going to infinity this way. But here it is not going to infinity. Here it is here only. This part is here only. And I want magnetic field at this point. So then what I should do? Draw this line to find alpha. I have to draw this line. But this point is at infinity. This point is at infinity. No. So if I draw this line, alpha will be 90 now. Can anybody say what will be beta now? So I have to draw this line. So if I draw that line, so this is B, no? So if I draw this PB line now, it will coincide with this R. So this line will coincide with this. So what will be beta? 0. So now if you check the formula, how much it will be? There's to directly, this is sine 90, 1, sine 0, 0. So it will be mu naught I by 4 pi r. Again, very easy to remember. For full infinite wire, it was mu naught I by 2 pi r. This is also called sometimes semi-infinite. But that is very funny because half of infinity is infinity only, but still they call this semi-infinite. Okay. Right, quickly. And sometimes they will give you like this. Okay. The wire is like this and point P is here. This is 60 degree and this is 30 degree. Current is I. Then here I will not substitute, just I will tell you alpha is 60 degree here, beta is 30 degree. So just put alpha 60 degree, beta 30 degree, and if they give you the current value, you can check. And R is always this perpendicular distance. Third one. Okay. So from this perpendicular line, this is alpha, this is beta. Fourth one, you have to be slightly careful. This is the last one, last case I mean. They will give you sometimes like this. And your point will, this is the wire, okay, AB. And your point is here. So in that case, what you should do is first you should find, your, even if the wire may not come till here, you have to extend the line and this will be your R perpendicular. So R perpendicular will not change. It is still the perpendicular distance between the point and the line of the wire. Then you have to extend these two lines, no? So extend those two lines. Now let us say this is given as 30 degree, 60 degree, and this is given as 30 degree. Okay, then in this formula, current you know, R you know. What will be alpha? So alpha, if you check, is this way. So alpha will be 60 degree. Beta, while when I wrote this formula, beta was down, remember, down. But in this question, beta is up. So I have to write minus 30. If I don't do that, I will get wrong answer. Okay? Because when I wrote this formula, I have taken beta positive here. So if this beta is up, you have to write minus. And those students who want, no sir, I want down negative, then you have to write minus here. So that down you can take negative, up you can take positive. But this is how I remember easily. So this is alpha, this is beta, I write here. Sometimes they give this kind of wire where one of the angle, alpha is still up only like this, but beta here is up only. But in the derivative, in the formula which I wrote, beta is taken down. Here beta is up. So you have to put minus. That is important because sine of minus is not sine. Sine of minus theta is not sine theta. Sine of minus theta is minus sine theta. So you need to know this rule. Okay. So now we will do the next topic. This is all about straight wires. Problem solving we will do later. Now we will derive one formula which is again important for your board exam. Magnetic field on the axis of a infinite long solenoid. Long solenoid. Okay. Magnetic field on the axis of an infinite long solenoid. So first before starting the derivations and all, let us understand what is solenoid. So if you take some rod like this, this is not rod, I know, but some cylindrical object, then take some wire and put the wire like this. Okay, like this. It should be closely wound, closely tight. Okay, the gap between them should be nothing. So one after another like this you have to do, and then after doing, let me fast forward many times, then you remove this one, then you get one cylindrical shape kind of object which has actually circular turns, that we called solenoid. Okay, so in diagram it is impossible for me to show, you know, they are tight, so don't draw this one. Okay, don't draw right now. So it will look like this. So this is how the solenoid will look. Okay, students. Now let us say I pass current like this. So the current will go like this, here like this, up here like this. Like this will come, and it has to be very long. If I know nothing is infinite, so when I say in physics infinite, it means it should be very long. So compared to this diameter, this length should be very large. Now I am interested to know magnetic field somewhere inside here. That is the question. Okay, students. Now listen carefully. First, you have to know how magnetic field lines look like. If you don't know that, you cannot apply Ampere's circuital law. Now, since this is circular and I want near the center, you know that for each circle it is like this, right? The current is flowing like this. So if I put my thumb along the current, it will be like this. So magnetic field inside will look like this. Inside. Now, some of you may think, "Arey, wait, sir, wait. You told at the center it will be like this." At the center, outside it will be like this. You told, sir, we remember that diagram which you made. Yes, it is correct only. It will look like this. However, it is infinite, no? So since it is infinite, these lines, this curved lines, that they will have to go like this and come out like that. Since it is infinite, it will keep going. So near the middle part of the solenoid, you can imagine magnetic field will be uniform. Okay, so due to each circle, the magnetic field is like this, I know. And here, in not at the center, but somewhere here or here, I know it should be curved like this. However, it is infinite, so it never gets chance to get curved. It keeps on going like this. So here, magnetic field inside will be uniform. Outside, magnetic field can be taken as zero, because it keeps on going and then will be somewhere there. So if the solenoid is very long, you can do this assumption that inside the magnetic field is uniform, direction will be given by this, again same rule, outside magnetic field is zero. Okay, students, fine. The first thing we will define is something called small n. Now in current electricity chapter, small n was number of free electrons per unit volume, that is different, that is number density. Here n is number of turns per unit length. Okay, number of turns per unit length. So I told you, you have to make many turns like this, right? So take some length, count how many turns are there, divide the number of turns by the length. That is called number of turns per unit length, small n. Basically, it is nothing but number of turns divided by length. Number of turns divided by length. Okay. First, we have to do this. Second, we are not going to draw this diagram here because that is a little complicated. So in exam, what you have to do is this. Look here, all of you. Look here, okay? So current is going like this. Okay? Let me show once more, like this. So near the bottom, current is entering the board or coming out? For this line, current is going inside or coming out? Look here, again let me show. So here current is going inside or out. You are understanding? Current is going like this. So here current is going inside. Yeah, in. So we will show this part by drawing like this. And here we will draw dot. So basically, what we will do? We will do something like this. Something like this. And here we will draw dots. Here we will draw cross. Okay, so current is going out, in, out, in, out, in, out, in. So these are your direction of current. Okay, current. So this is how in textbooks they do, so that it looks little easier to solve. Out, in, out, in, out, in, out, in, out, in. Okay, students, fine. Now I want magnetic field here. You know that if current is going like this, magnetic field will be like this, right here. So this is your magnetic field lines. Let me use red color for magnetic field lines. So this is your magnetic field lines. Don't draw too many also. If you draw too many, it will become very dirty. Okay. So this is your magnetic field lines. Now I need to choose loop. Be careful. Your magnetic field lines are not circular this time. It is actually uniform, like this. So don't choose circular loop. Then angle you will not be able to find. So what I will do? I will choose a loop which is like this. So this is my Amperean loop. Amperean loop. Okay, this is my Amperean loop, and let us call this A, B, C, D. This length, let me write L. This one, no need. You will see why no need. Okay, so A, B, C, D is my Amperean loop. Now I will calculate the left side of Ampere circuital law. Integral B dot dl. This integration is always done along the Amperean loop, just like in Gauss law we used to do integration along the closed Gaussian surface. Here it is along the loop. So this is basically your ABCD loop. Okay, students, so you have to take this dot product for this loop. I will divide this into four parts because there are four parts, you can see. So A to B, B dot dl plus B, sorry. Now don't put circle, okay? Because A to B is not closed. No, A to B is not closed. A, B, C, D, A is closed. A, B, C, D, A is closed. But this is not closed, so don't put circle here. So first integrate A to B, then B to C, then C to D, write it near C to D. All this should be in one line, and then from D to A. D to A. Okay. So what I have done, this left side of Ampere circuital law, I am calculating. Now look carefully. For part AB, for this part, DL is along the loop, I told. So the loop is like this, magnetic field is also like this. So for part AB, theta is 0. Everybody understood, I think. The loop is like this. Which way you go, that is up to you. Better to go in that way where theta will be 0. Why 180 you want unnecessary? So go in this direction. So if you go this way, DL will be here. Magnetic field is also here, so theta will be 0. For part BC and DA, this one I will say later, DA. You can see I have to move this way in the loop, but magnetic field is this way. So theta is 90 degree. And for part DC, there is no magnetic field outside. outside of the loop VTP is zero. Here it is zero, right? I told you already. And that is true because you have infinite loop, infinite solenoid, sorry. So keeping in mind these angles, let us see what happens. So closed integral, line integral of magnetic field around a closed loop will be, this will become A to B, B dl cos 0. Here cos 0, na? Cos 0. This one will be 90 degrees, so this will be out. B to C, this will be 0. Let us write 0 directly, no problem. 0. For this part, CD part, D itself is 0. See, for CD part, B itself is 0. Outside here, there is no magnetic field. So this is also 0. And this is also 0 because here theta is 90. Here theta is 90. Here theta is 90. Okay, so wherever theta is 90, dot product should be 0. Because dot product contains cos theta. A bar dot B bar is A B cos theta. Cross product contains sine theta. You must remember that. So you can see this result becomes very simple now. So finally you can see your integral B dot dl will be, this is 0, this is 0, this is, this third part is 0. Don't cancel like this in exam. So this 3 will cancel out. So basically only this is left. Now you know cos 0 is 1. And since inside magnetic field is uniform, you can take it outside. So it will be integration of BL from where to where? A to B. That will be how much? If you integrate DL, 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 you get total length. Total length from A to B, I wrote small l. So small l. So this is the left side of your, left side of your what? Ampere circuital law. Now I want to find the right side. In the right side, what we have? Current. Mu naught is there, but mu naught I will write later. First, let me calculate current enclosed by the loop. So what is the current enclosed by the loop? Be careful, students. Be careful. This is the last part. After this, it will be done. Now look carefully. Each turn carries I current. Now look carefully. We have to calculate what here? We have to calculate current that is coming out of this Amperean loop. Right? Don't draw this. Just try to understand. This is the surface. So you have to find current coming out. Now in my diagram, you can see there are 3 turns. 1 turn, 2 turn, 3 turn. Right? 1i, 2i, 3i. So what will be the current inside this? 3i. But that is because I made 3 turns. So to find current enclosed inside the loop, what you should calculate inside this loop, what is the current coming out? Very simple. Number of turns into current. Yes or no? Number of turns into current. Now what will be number of turns? Small n is what? Number of turns per unit length. So if you cross multiply with length, you will get number of turns. I want current inside this rectangle. Matlab in this length. So it will be small n is the number of turns per unit length, into this length only, because only these turns are inside. These ones are outside, these ones are outside. Outside one, better, we don't want. Only inside one. So you have to count how many turns are there. How many turns will be there? N into L. Why? Because N is number of turns per unit length. So in 1 meter, N turns. In 2 meter, 2N. In L meter, NL. So this is the number of turns. And each turn carries I current. No, I like that. So I. Equation 2. So you can see both sides we have calculated. Now finally, no need of this diagram. So now finally we have to say, using Ampere's circuital law, first write the law. integral B dot dl, line integral around a closed path is equal to mu naught times current enclosed, or I can write current inside. I don't know what I wrote, whatever, okay, inside. So what is this part? This part I found BL. And what is current enclosed inside? NLI. You can see small l was arbitrary, so it has to cancel, right? Because anyone can choose any length, so that should not change the formula of magnetic field. So this l will cancel, and finally a very simple result will come. Magnetic field inside a long solenoid is mu naught NI. I is the current in the solenoid, N is number of turns per meter. Thank you. Any doubt, you can call me, discuss with me, or you can message me. So some of you may have seen this in class 10 also, this formula. In electromagnets they use, okay? Please revise everyone. Thank you.